Hello, good evening everyone. I am Dr. Ayman Das, online resource person for English language teacher. So today let's talk about Concord, one of the important grammatical areas for competitive learners. Concord is nothing but, you know, a subject verb agreement. Subject verb agreement. So in a sentence you are using subject, verb, object. The verbs you use in a sentence, you should agree with the subject. So this is a very important area where you need to concentrate on this issue. For example, they are playing football. They are playing football. So why do we use are? Are is a plural verb. Plural verb. We use plural verb because we have plural subject. Plural subject. So therefore, verb should agree with the subject. Plural verb. Therefore, we use plural subject. When we use plural subject, it goes without saying we should use plural verb. So verb should agree with the subject in number and in person. She is preparing a cup of coffee. She is preparing a cup of coffee. So this is singular verb. Singular verb. Therefore, why do we use singular verb? We use singular verb because we use singular subject. Singular subject. She is a singular subject. Therefore, we use singular verb. She is preparing a cup of coffee. She is drawing some sketches. So she is cooking food. So is a singular. She is a singular subject. Therefore we use singular verb. So this singular verb should coincide with singular subject. Similarly, plural verb are should be suitable to the plural subject. So this is what we call subject verb agreement. Students of competitive examination should understand the fact that verb should agree with the subject in number, in person. So this is the main idea we are going to discuss in detail. So Concord means subject verb agreement. Don't forget this phrase. Subject verb agreement. So look at this. A verb must agree with its subject in number and person. You need not memorize the rules. Just you understand what Concord means. Verb must agree with its subject. Must agree with its subject in person, total and number. Look at this word. A goat eats grass. A goat eats grass. A goat. Singular subject. Singular subject. Therefore, in order to make this verb as a singular verb, we are adding s. We are adding s to it. So, a goat is a singular subject. Therefore, we use singular verb plus eats. So, a goat eats grass. Why do we add yes? Why do we add yes? We want to change this verb into singular verb. If you don't add yes to EAT, verb, it's a plural. If you want to change this plural verb into singular verb, you must add s to it. So therefore, is. So this is a singular verb. It's a singular verb. Eats is a singular verb. Eats is a singular verb. Why do we change it into a singular verb? We change it into a singular verb because of the singular subject. A goat is the singular subject. Since a goat is the singular subject, we must change the verb into singular verb by adding s into the verb. S to the verb. Similarly, tigers eat flesh. Tigers eat flesh. So in the previous example, a goat is a singular subject. In the second example, tigers, plural subject. Plural subject. Therefore, verb should be in plural verb. Please note down, s is not added to the verb eat, as in the case of previous one. Tigers, plural subject, therefore it accepts plural verb. This is plural verb. If you change one for the other, then you are making mistakes. You always remember, you should use singular subject to singular verb, plural subject to plural verb. This is what we call concord, subject-verb agreement. A goat eats grass, tigers eat flesh. A goat singular subject followed by singular verb. Tigers plural verb followed by plural. Tigers plural subject followed by plural verb. This is very very important. Verb is the deciding factor. The verb must agree with its real subject and not anything that immediately precedes. So when I explain the rule, please kindly listen to me. The verb must agree with its real subject. Not immediately precede it. What is the real subject? Each of is the real subject. Neither of is the real subject. A box of is the real subject. With these real subject, a verb should agree with it. With these real subjects, verb should agree with it. Where is the verb here? Was is the verb. The second sentence was here. So singular beaver, singular beaver, singular beaver. Why do we use singular beaver? We use singular beaver because the real subject is in singular. This is singular. Each of is singular, neither of singular, a box of singular. Real subject in all the three examples, real subjects in all the three examples are singular, therefore we use singular verb. Therefore we use singular verb. A box of cakes is on the table. So what's the real problem is, some students might give importance for this word. Some students might, for example, each of the participants was given a pen. Neither of the combatants was able to win a decisive victory. A box of cakes is on the table. The students who do not know the rule, may think participants, plural subject, therefore the use of was wrong. They think, the students who do not know the rule, like the verb must agree with its real subject and not anything that immediately precede. If any student do not know this rule, giving importance for the preceding subject, participants, which is also plural, therefore they select to replace was by were. This is wrong. This is not the real subject. Participants is not the real subject. Combatant is not a real subject. Cake is not the real subject.
So what is the rule?
Verb should agree with the real subject. What is the real subject? Each of is the real subject. Neither of is the real subject. A box of is the real subject. Before you provide appropriate verb in each sentence, you should consider the real subject, which is each of, neither of, a box of. The real subject should not be participants, comparators, cake like that. Therefore, when you come across similar examples, you must be very patient and passive. You must read the examples 3 to 5 times, and you must understand what are the real subjects, or are there any real subjects? Are there any subjects teasing us, misleading us? Like that you should think. But all of a sudden you should not work and you should not provide the answer immediately. So therefore most of the students will be carried away by looking at the plural subject, like participants, comparators, cakes. So what I am trying to say is, this is not the real subject. Participant is not the real subject. Comparator is not the real subject. Cakes is not the real subject. The real subject is each of, neither of, a box of. All the real subjects are singular in nature. All the real subjects are singular in nature. Therefore, we should use singular verb. Please note down the use of singular verb was in the second sentence, was also in the first sentence, and is the third sentence. 1, 2, 3. If you want to know. 2 and 3. So, from this slide, you must understand what is real subject and what are the plural nouns which should be ignored. So, participants should be ignored, comparator should be ignored, cakes should be ignored, because the real subjects are not there. These are not the real subjects. The real subjects are each of, neither of, a box of, etc. etc. And then, two singular nouns joined by and. Two singular nouns joined by and express one idea. Two singular nouns. Slow, one singular noun. Steady, another singular noun. Age, singular noun. Experience. The horse and carriage, singular noun. Two singular nouns are connected by and. So, it conveys one idea or single idea. Single idea. Though there are two nouns connected by and, it conveys only single idea or one idea. In such a similar sentence, we should always use singular. This is very, very important. Even though this sentence is constructed with the help of two singular nouns, these two singular nouns, when they are connected by and, since they convey one meaning, one idea, single idea, we have to use only singular. What is the singular verb in the first sentence? 1, 2, 3. So, wins, singular, singular. If you write win simply, this is a plural verb. Plural verb. If you want to make it a singular, then you must add here. Wins. So this is singular. Similarly, brings also singular. Similarly, is. So, the horse and carriage is at the door. The horse and carriage. You cannot separate horse from carriage. You cannot separate carriage from horse. So both the things are considered to be a cart. Cart, C-A-R-T. You want to say cart. Then you cannot detach carriage from horse. You cannot detach horse from carriage. Similarly, age and experience. Singular theme. Age and experience. Conveys singular theme, one idea, single idea. Age and experience brings wisdom to man. Wisdom, knowledge plus experience. Knowledge plus courage. Wisdom, knowledge plus courage. Slow and steady wins the race. This is also slow one noun and steady another noun. But both these two nouns convey single idea. Slow and steady wins the race. Slow and steady wins the race. So similarly, bread and butter. Bread and butter is my breakfast. Is my breakfast. Remember, my dear students, even though we use two different nouns, they convey single idea, one idea. Since we use only one idea, we must use only singular verb. When we want to convert plural verb into a singular verb, we must add s to the plural verb. Win plus s. So slow and steady wins the race. Age and experience brings wisdom to man. The horse and carriage is at the door. And bread and butter is my today's breakfast. So bread and butter, breakfast. Even though there are two things. They make item of breakfast. So please, you must understand the word. Two singular nouns joined by an together express one idea, that is breakfast here, that is winning and then bringing wisdom to man. So conveying one idea, even though there are two different things, slow and steady, age and experience, horse and carriage. So, two nouns joined by an. My uncle one noun and guardian another noun. One, two. Two nouns joined by an refer to the same person, take a singular. Note down the singular. Why do we use singular verb here? The use of singular verb stands correct. Correct. Why is it correct? Seemingly there are two different persons, but it is not so. My uncle and guardian. My uncle and guardian. Please note down this my possessive case. Possessive case. It is called my means personal possessive. Personal possessive. But don't worry to remember this technical term. Even if you don't remember, don't worry. For your reference, I write this personal possessive. So personal possessive is used just before the first subject article. We don't use possessive case just before another subject. Possessive case is used only just before the. So therefore, my uncle and guardian refers to the same person. Same person. How do I say my uncle and guardian is the same person? Because a possessive case is used just before the first subject. First noun. Possessive case is not used against the second subject. So from this clue, we get an idea that both uncle and guardian it's the same person, not different person. So therefore we use singular verb. My uncle and guardian has given his consent. My uncle and guardian has given his consent. Which means my uncle and guardian is the same person, not two different persons. So in the second example also, please note down the use of definite article. Definite article. The definite article is used just before the first noun, not before the second noun. The principal and the chairman of the school is on leave today. So note down the use of singular verb. Singular verb. Because in definite article, the is used just before the first noun, first subject. So kindly remember two things. One is personal possessive, my, is like that. My uncle, his uncle, our uncle, their uncles. Possessive case, the use of possessive case one. Second one, the use of definite article or indefinite article like that. Generally speaking, if any noun preceded by either personal possessive or definite article or indefinite article, refer to single person. So here possessive case, definite article, indefinite article are used just against the first subject, not the second subject. So personal possessive, definite article and indefinite articles are used just before the first subject, not in the second. When they are used in front of the first subject, then we should use singular. This is the principal, not again the is used before the second subject chairman or second noun chairman. So possessive case and definite article or indefinite article are used just in front of the first subject or just before the first subject. There is no usage of the indefinite or definite or person possessive just against the just before the second subject. Please remember this. You should always use singular when possessive case was used just before the first subject. So now you don't read the rules now, just you apply. So now look at this. So kindly remember the previous examples. Earlier it was only one usage, my uncle. Now again the my is repeated. My uncle and my guardian. So in two different places, possessive case twice was used. So my uncle and my guardian is two different persons. How do you say there are two different persons? There are two different persons because personal possessive is used just before the first subject and before the second subject also. So in the previous example, possessive case or indefinite or definite articles were used just before the first subject alone. But in the second example, the possessive case my is used just before the first noun and just before the second noun also. Therefore, we use plural verb. My uncle and my guardian have given their consent to my plan. My uncle one person, my guardian another person, therefore plural. Similarly, the principal and the chairman two different persons. Principal is one and chairman is another one, therefore there are two people. Then who are on leave. So the use of plural verb is correct. Plural verb. In the previous case, we had used is. The principal one person, the chairman is another person, therefore there are two subjects, two different subjects. As a result, we are using plural verb. So kindly note down the personal possessive. Personal possessive in two places. Two places. And then definite. Definite article. Definite. So now you read.
when two nouns joined by an refer to two different persons, the article or personal possessive pronoun should be repeated after and. That is after and. This is after and. After and again we are using possessive. After and again we are using different article. So only after you have understood this explanation, then you can read and understand. Only with the help of the examples I taught you, you can understand the rules. So that's why I suggested you not to read before you understand the content. Not to read the rules before you understand the content. So possessive case my was used in two different subjects. Just before two different subjects. Therefore, plural verb should be used. The principal first noun, the chairman second noun. So both these nouns are connected by and. And also definite article the was also used in just before two different subjects. Therefore, it goes without saying that we should use plural verb or. So this is correct. And then two singular nouns connected by and, preceded by each and every, take a singular. So look at this, each boy singular, each girl singular, connected by and. So it will take singular verb. Singular verb. Why? Because boy is a subject which is preceded by singular phrase, each boy, each girl. Okay, boy and girl connected by and, preceded by each and every. So therefore its function is changed, its character is changed, singular character. When it is preceded by each, then it will become singular, each boy and each girl. Even though these two phrases are connected by and, we should use only singular verb because it is preceded, because the noun is preceded by each boy and each girl. Look at the second example, every soldier and every civilian. Every soldier and every civilian has singular verb. Every soldier and every civilian has to be ready to sacrifice his life for the country. Every soldier has to be ready. Every civilian has to be ready to sacrifice his life for the country. Each boy has a vote. Each girl has a vote. So when we combine, this is the resultant product of the sentence. Each boy and each girl has a vote. And don't get misled by looking at the word and connected by each boy and each girl. Most of the students may think each boy and each girl, we should provide plural verb. This is wrong, they may say. So we are wrong. So two singular nouns connected by and, two singular nouns connected by and, preceded by each, preceded by each, take a singular, as a singular. So line by line understanding will make your understanding of grammar very stronger. And then two subjects joined by or, either or, neither nor. Not only but also agree with the second subject. So you must understand there are two subjects joined by either or, neither nor, not only but also. In those sentences, the verb should agree with the second subject. So
Either he or I am to sing the prayer song. Neither the headmaster nor the teachers were present at the meeting. Not only the minister but also his supporters are guilty of the charge. So, two subjects. He is the one subject. I is another subject. Neither the headmaster one subject nor the teacher another subject. The third sentence, the minister one subject, his supporters are another subject. So in the selection of verb, the selection of verb, second subject should alone be considered. We will consider only the second subject for the provision of the verb. Understand? Two subjects joined by either or, neither nor, not only but also. The verb agrees with the second subject. What's the second subject in the first example? The second subject in the first example is I. What is the appropriate verb should be used? Am is the one. So therefore the use of am is correct. We don't use is. We don't use are because singular subject I. After I we should use only am. Am is there already, therefore this is wrong. So this is right. Second subject is the deciding factor for the verb. Either he or I dash to sing the prayer song means am should be provided. So this is second subject. Second subject should select the verb where plural subject. Plural subject. This is plural verb. Plural verb. This is right. Second subject is the plural verb. Why do we use plural verb where here? This is a plural subject. Second subject is plural, therefore verb should also be plural. The third sentence, second subject is also plural, supporters, plural subject. Plural subject, therefore we use plural verb. Plural verb. Or neither the supporters, neither the supporters nor the headmaster present at the meeting. Present at the meeting. What is your answer now? Neither the supporters first subject, the headmaster second subject. So what is the answer? What is your answer? What type of verb will you use? Singular verb or plural? For the selection of verb, we should consider the second subject. What is the second subject? Headmaster is the second subject, which is singular, therefore is should be used. Second subject is the deciding factor. So therefore, second subject is singular subject, therefore we should use singular verb. So in the original sentence, first subject is headmaster, the second subject is teachers. Therefore we used plural verb. I have just changed the order. Neither the supporters plural, first subject. Nor the headmaster, singular subject, second subject, which is the deciding factor. Therefore, we use this. So, second subject decides the selection of verb. And selection of verb. And then, the subject majority can be singular or plural. Subject majority. So kindly note down this rule. If majority is used alone, it's singular. And the majority is followed by a plural noun, it takes it. Look at this example. The majority believes that he will win the match. The majority. Majority believes. The majority is singular subject. Singular subject, therefore, singular verb should be used with the phrase majority. Therefore, believe plus yes is done. Singular subject, the majority, attached with the beliefs. The majority believes that he will win the match. He will win the match. Singular subject followed by singular verb. Singular. If you write believe, this is plural verb. Believe plus yes, singular. The majority believes that he will win the match. So look at the second example. The majority of the students believe him to be innocent. The majority of the students. What is the rule? The majority is followed by a plural noun. Once you use the word majority, and then the word majority is followed by a plural noun like students. Majority, majority of the students. Majority of the students. Majority of the students believe him to be innocent. Once you use the word majority followed by plural subject, the students, plural subject. In that case, we should use plural verb. Believe is a plural verb. Believe is a plural verb. Majority followed by singular verb. Because no other plural verb, you cannot see after the word the majority. We have just used the phrase the majority. So there is no other plural subjects we have used after the word majority. But in the second sentence, we have used plural subject after the word the majority. Therefore, the majority of the students, if you come across phrase like this, please remember you should always use plural verb. So if there is no any extension of idea, extension of points after the word majority, please use only singular verb. So this is the rule. If majority is used alone, if majority is used lonely or used alone, it's a singular verb. Means you use singular subject, you use singular verb. If majority is used alone, you should use singular verb. Singular verb. If the majority followed by plural noun, it takes plural verb. It is already there. This is already there. And the same is applicable to the word. A number of. See, again, the majority singular verb. The majority plus plural subjects use plural verb. Plural. Similarly, a number of phrase. A number of is used with the plural verb. Look at the example. A number of teachers were present at the meeting. A number of teachers were present at the meeting. A number of teachers. A number of teachers. So this is a noun phrase. Noun phrase. And divide this noun phrase like this. Number of teachers. A number of teachers were present. So plural indication. Plural indication, therefore we should use plural verb. Plural, a number of. Please remember, the majority singular, the majority followed by plural noun should use plural verb. Similarly, a number of followed by
A plural subject or any other subjects should take plural verb. The number of teachers, plurals, plural subjects, remember.
Similarly, the number of, take singular verb. This is important, singular. The number of takes a singular verb. Look at the example, second. The number of absentees in the class is increasing. The number of absentees in the class is increasing. The number of absentees, noun phrase. Draw a line like this. The number, singular subject. Singular subject will take singular verb. Singular verb. The number of followed by plural. The number of followed by singular. Remember. The number of followed by plural verb. The number of followed by singular. The majority follows singular. The majority of the students, the majority plus plural subject follows plural. See, note down this flow. When two subjects are joined by the phrases like, as well as, and not, along with, together with, besides, in addition to, accompanied by, like, unlike, etc. The verb agrees with the first subject. When two subjects are joined by the phrases, For example, the principal together with his wife and sons. Where is together and together with? Used. The principal together with his wife and sons has attended the function. When you look at the second subject with his wife and sons, you may think this answer is incorrect, because with his wife and sons seem to be plural subjects, therefore you may think plural verb should be used. Instead of as, you should think have should be used. You may think it is wrong, it is acceptable, it is unacceptable answer. The principal together with his wife and sons has attended the function. So you can think differently. For example, together with his wife and sons. This is the first subject. Principal is the first subject. This is second subject. Together with his wife and sons is the second subject. Second subject, which is not important, and also this role to select the verb is nothing. So, and also this is additional information. Together with his wife and sons gives us an additional information about the principal. So this additional information is not necessary for the selection of the verb. For the selection of the verb, what is important? The principal main subject is important. So therefore, eliminating this phrase from the sentence, this sentence can give you complete sense. This sentence makes complete sense. For example, the principal has attended the meeting. You can get complete sense. This sentence gives you complete sense. By omitting together with his wife and sons from the sentence. So together with his wife and sons is additional information. And also second subject, For the selection of verb, the second subject should be ignored. Therefore, first subject should be considered. So the first subject, the principle is singular, therefore singular verb should be used. Singular. So as students of English language, what you should understand is, you should understand together with his wife and sons, his additional information, whose role in the selection of verb is nothing, who has nothing to do with the selection of verb. Then who has the role? Only the principal has the role, because the principal is the main subject. That is the first subject. This is the second subject. Second subject doesn't have any role at all. The principal together with his wife and sons has attended the function. Some students who are quick, fast, swift and inattentive sometime may do here in this example, looking at the second subject. Second subject is not important in this example. Similarly, look at this. Harish is responsible for this, because as well as Manoj is additional information. Additional information or additional news. Additional. Harish, singular subject. Singular. Singular. Sir, what about Manoj? Additional information. Whose role is nothing in the selection of verb. So Harish. Harish is responsible for this. Murali, not his brothers. Additional information. Murali and not his brothers. So Murali is singular subject. Therefore singular verb. And then the students along with their class teachers. Additional information. So the students are going on a tour. The students, plural. First subject, plural subject. First subject, plural subject. Murali, first subject, singular subject. Harish, first subject, singular subject. The students, first subject, plural, therefore plural. Plural. Murali, singular subject, singular verb. Singular. Harish, singular subject, singular. So, additional information has no role in the selection of. Please try to understand this and apply in your day to day exam. And then, the collective noun is usually in singular number, collective noun. What's collective noun? Committee is a collective noun, jury is a collective noun, family is a collective noun, society is a collective noun, staff is a collective noun, school is a collective noun, university is a collective noun. So, collective noun is usually a singular noun. So, when a collective noun is considered as a single unit, it is singular. When a collective noun is considered as a single unit or as a whole unit. As a whole unit. I will explain more. Look at the example. So, committee is one of the collective nouns. The committee is meeting today to discuss its problems. The committee, collective noun. Here collective noun is used as a singular. The committee is meeting today to discuss its problem. Committee as a whole. As a whole. As a whole.
Committee consists of chairman, committee consists of president, committee consists of cashier, committee consists of executive members. So inclusive of all the members, represents something called committee. Committee as a whole. Don't look at chairman of the committee as a separate one. Don't look at the president of the committee separate one. Committee as a whole is meeting today to discuss its problem. Committee's problem. So we must look at the committee as a whole. Committee is meeting today to discuss his problem. Similarly, the jury has passed his verdict. Verdict means judgment. The jury has passed his verdict. Jury means consists of members, consists of chairman, as I told you in the case of committee. It's a whole unit. Not single unit, not single member it is referred to, it is being referred to. So look at the example. First of all, before you select whether the collective noun is singular or plural, you must understand the meaning behind the sentence. You must understand the meaning behind the sentence. The committee is meeting today is. So it gives you a clue. Committee is used as singular one. Therefore, it should be used as a whole unit. While discussing this problem, another group, singular unit. Committee is meeting today to discuss its problem. Committee as a whole. Chairman, treasurer, joint secretary, president, executive members, non-members. So all these factors include the name of committee. Jury also. So now look at the second, look at the next slide, then so you will get understand. Now look at this. Third and fourth. The committee are divided in their opinion. Committee, now individual unit, individual. When the collective noun refers to the individual members, the committee are divided means the individual members in the committee are divided. The committee are divided in their opinion or in their options. In their options. The jury are arguing among themselves. The committee means members. Individual members. The jury are arguing among the members means now the collective noun jury is as a plural subject. Plural subject. Committee is also used as a plural subject. Talks about the members, individual members. Jury also. Therefore we use plural verb. Plural verb. This is correct. So in the previous case we used singular verb. Because committee was used as a whole thing. Jury was also used as a whole thing, therefore whole unit, therefore we used singular. But here committee means referring to the individual members in the committee, individual members in the jury. Therefore individual members constitute plural things, therefore we use plural verb. I hope now you understand the better things. Collective noun or how can we use collective nouns? What type of verbs can we use against the collective noun? Now you can understand. So now I have given you a list of collective nouns. I have given you some nouns which are considered to be collective nouns. Just casually go through this. Council, association, audience, class, club, college, committee, community, company, crowd,
department, family, generation, government, firm, group, orchestra, population, press, public, school, staff, team, and university. So these are all standing references for collective noun. Please understand two things. It can be used as a singular and also a plural. How? There are two things. Whole unit and referring to individual member. Another part. Individual members. When you want to use it individual member, then you can use plural verb. If it is whole unit, please use singular. Plural verb is singular. Individual member, if you want to talk about collective noun as individual members, then please use plural. If you want to talk about collective noun as a whole unit, then please use singular. Kindly go through this list. This list is not exhaustive. If you want to learn more about, please refer to Wren and Martin and other grammars. Wren and Martin is the basic one. You can get through some of the matters and go for higher books on grammar. So without mastering certain things from Wren and Martin, don't go for any other higher order grammar books. This is my personal suggestion. Collective nouns, there are two things you have to bear in your mind. You must consider collective noun as a whole unit, one, and individual unit. And then, distances, heights, amounts of money. So certain things, my dear friend, you remember. You cannot read every rules and regulations from grammar book, and you cannot get mastery over it. Whenever you look at examples, either from this form of sentences, etc., etc., you can get to know that. How is the rule applicable to each and every sentence? Now you kindly look at the words, I put them into rectangular shape or underline like that. Distances, heights, amounts of money represent a single figure or quantity. Therefore, single figure and quantity will take only singular. Single figure or single quantity. For example, 1,000 rupees. 1,000 rupees. Quantity of money. Amounts of money. 1,000 rupees. Some students who are weak in grammar may understand 1,000 rupees is plural one. Therefore, is wrong. Therefore, is replaced and R is substituted, thinking that 1,000 rupees is plural subject. It is not so. Amounts of money represent a single figure. Amounts of money represents, amounts of money indicates single figure or single quantity. Therefore, when quantity is single, then you must use singular. Is correct. But seemingly, when student looking at plural subject may get misled. Therefore, is wrong. They may think. It's wrong. 1,000 rupees is not a huge sum today. Okay? 1,000 rupees, what's the rule? Amount of money. Then 15 miles is not a great distance. 15 miles is not a great distance. 15 miles again. This is singular. This is singular, not plural. 15 miles. Distance. Distance represents single figure. Distance, whether they are mentioned in plural. Now, don't worry about that. Distances, when they represent single figure, we must use singular. Then 4 kilos of sugar. 4 kilos of sugar. Quantity. 4 kilos of sugar. Note down costs. Cost plus S. Singular. a plural number applies to distances, heights, amounts of money and represent a single figure or quantity, it takes singular verb. Please note down in all the three sentences, we have just noted that singular verbs are used in all the three sentences. Taking into account the rules of distances, heights, amounts of money, etc. etc. So, my dear young learners, as far as competitive exams are concerned, there is no question paper omitting a question from CONCORD. So, in every year, there are 2 to 4 questions are coming from CONCORD. Therefore, please take care, attention. Please take too much time on exploring many more rules from CONCORD. CONCORD is nothing but a kind of subject-verb agreement. If you use plural subject, you should use plural verb. If you use singular subject, you should use singular subject. Singular subject, you should use with singular verb. Plural subject, plural verb. The singular subject is singular verb. And vice versa. So kindly recall the rules we have just seen by using all these things. Have a nice day. We shall meet again. Thank you very much.